How's it going, guys? Welcome back to Milton Adrian's channel. Today I've been sent the Sumvision Raijin-X Gaming Mouse, so we're going to have a quick unboxing of this and have a look at it. Just plug it in and see what it looks like. So this is the front of the box here. If you are getting it in a store or what have you, but most people are probably just buying this online due to the current pandemic anyway. But yeah, it shows you the Raijin-X Gaming Mouse, what it looks like. We've got the RGB, you know, kind of featured there as well. It's got 12,400 DPI, this thing, so that's quite a lot. So be interested to see how well it performs. Hopefully it won't stutter or anything like that. 30G acceleration. It's also got macro software as well, which you can download from the Sumvision website, you know, to fiddle around with that there. On the side, again, 12,400 DPI. And then on the back, you've got some quick settings there. So 16.8 million RGB customization options. You've got the PixArt 3327 sensor as well. You've got the 6 fully programmable buttons, all that kind of stuff. But you can have a look at that, you know, a bit close up when on the B-roll. So yeah, let's just open this thing up. Let's have a look. So, now, slide it out. What's funny is you actually get like a little plastic window here in the packaging, but it doesn't have a flap on the front here to look at it before you open the box, so that's a bit strange. But anyway, flip an oversight. So we've got the online chat, warranty information, support and all that that you get from Sumvision, so that's pretty cool. You also get a user manual, you know, quick setup, how to use the mouse and stuff like that, where to download the software from, so check that out definitely. You also get this, which is pretty cool, which I'll explain what that is in a second. Then obviously you got your mouse itself. Now, first impressions are this is a very, very lightweight mouse, and you haven't got any removable weights in it or anything like that. So if you do like a lightweight mouse, you know, that you can just throw around, this is pretty cool. And it's got, if you look at the top here, you got a really cool mesh air vent system. So basically the idea is, if your hands get sweaty, you know, while you're gaming for a long time, then, you know, your air can go through the mouse, it's not just stuck on the mouse, and it can kind of, you don't get all the heat build up and stuff while you're sweating away gaming and all that kind of stuff. So that's pretty cool. But what they also do give you in this packet, which is another cool little feature. So say if you like the mouse itself, but you don't want this mesh kind of feel, you don't like it, because it is a little bit slippery because it is a plastic, you know, surface. What you can actually get is this rubber, like silicone pad. And what you do with this is you literally just throw it on top there, and it kind of like connects to the holes on the mesh. And like so, and then it kind of wraps around them holes, so you don't actually have to worry about them holes there if you want more grip. And you also get two for the mouse click section as well. Again, you're just gonna have to kind of push them into the holes a bit. Now they're not sticky, they just rely on the silicone rubber to try to hold it in place. But once you kind of push it on and make sure all the little grips on the other side of the rubber is on there, then it kind of stays in place really. You just got to make sure they're actually in the holes. It's a bit fiddly, to be honest, to get on. Like so, and there you go. I'm not sure how well it'll stay on that much when you're gaming, you know, dead quick or what have you, or you might brush it off. But first impressions are, you know, it'll probably do the job for what you want to use it for. I mean, but even like that, it actually feels more comfortable when you're holding it like that against the palm. It's like, it feels quite nice with the rubber silicone. And if you just want to take it off, you literally just peel it off and you can just chuck them away. Dead simple. Anyway, the braided cable is actually really, really thick, which is really good. You get a really thick braided cable, and this is actually thicker than some of my on the Corsair one I've got upstairs. And you also get a gold plated USB connector as well, which is always good. Even though the braid's thick, it feels a little bit loose around the actual wire itself, but you know, it probably won't be much of an issue. And you also get a little Velcro strap there if you want to wind it up. So on the bottom of the mouse, again, you've got the same vented kind of air vent perforation thing going on. You've also got a polling rate button as well on the bottom, so that's cool to see. And then not pretty much else really. I mean, you've got the a button there you can program. You've got your mouse button, you've got your left and right click as well. And you know, the buttons itself, they kind of feel quite nice as well. You know, the I mean, everyone's got a different preference. They're not like the best switches I've ever felt, but they feel like they'll do the job. I mean, for the price of this at the moment, it's £29, so about 30 quid, so it is quite cheap. Yeah, let's plug it in and see what it looks like with all the RGB lighting, and we'll have a look at that software as well. Alright guys, so I've got the mouse actually plugged in here to my PC. Now what you'll immediately notice is actually the LED effects actually look really good. I was quite impressed, to be honest, because what you normally find with cheaper mice is that they don't have as many LEDs where they should be, and you can clearly see where the actual LED starts and another one, one LED ends, another one starts, and you get these gaps. But the actual mouse itself doesn't really have any of that. So this is it as its default lighting. So it comes with this nice rainbow kind of light that's going all the way through the bottom there, which is really cool. And you also get the mouse scroll wheel lit up as well as the palm rest as well, so that's all lit up as well. And the LED is bright, it's decent, it looks really good, and it feels really nice as well. So obviously if you've got the silicone grip there actually on the mouse, then you know, obviously it's going to cover up the lighting. So I mean, if you're looking at a mouse like this, to be honest, you're probably not going to use that anyway, because you want it for that air vent. Obviously if you do have it on, then you're not going to see anything. But yeah, the LEDs look really cool. What I did notice is after I plugging it in and I looked at the software, you can't actually sync the mouse wheel and the palm rest LED to what's going on here. So the actual program itself only lets you control the LEDs that's going on here, with all the different effects and stuff like that. What these do, they are RGB, but they're actually synced to whatever DPI profile you've got. So it changes color based on what DPI profile you're using, and you can actually change the color of the you know, DPI profile LED as well if you want to. So say if I press that, you can see it changes to like green, you got your yellow, you know, you got your blue, you've got your red, and you've got your cyan, and then going back to your purple. So it's a bit strange because I had a good look around the software and I couldn't find it myself, how to get a way for it to sync up to this bottom one. If anyone knows a way, then, and you got this mouse, let us know in the comments, but I couldn't actually figure it out. But anyway, the mouse itself, I think it looks brilliant when it's lit up. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to look at the program as well, so I can show you that, so you can see what that looks like with the mouse, and I'm going to give you a closer look at the lighting effects on this thing. Alright guys, so here's the mouse itself. Now I'm just going to go through these different effects here so you can see what the LEDs look like. So at the moment it's set to rainbow. Now this is what it looks like on steady, so you can pick whichever colour you want. You know, blue, red, whatever you want to do. That's breathing there. So as you can see, obviously, like I mentioned before earlier, it only changes the base ring light. It doesn't actually change the DPI and the main palm rest section. Then you've got colorful tail. That's what this is one called. So it kind of pulses around the tail, which is pretty cool. Then you've got neon, which kind of goes from like, you know, cycles for all the different colors. This is colorful steady. It just lights up all the LEDs, but keeps them still. What else have we got here? We've got flicker, you know, so it looks like a bit of a rave. And you can choose two colors to pick what you want to change to. Then you've got, this one's called stars twinkle. So they kind of like just subtly kind of turn on and off different colors. You can change the speed of all these as well. So, you know, that's like on its slower speed there. And then, you know, there you've got like, that's the top speed. Then we've got wave, which kind of just goes around like that, which is basically like a bit more of a worse looking version than the rainbow one. And then obviously you can turn them all off as well if you don't want them on at all. So, you know, that's rainbow. Now, as I said before, you can change, you know, the DPI colors as well, you know, which one you wanna go for, that kind of thing. So, you know, there,
at the moment it's like purple, but you know, if you press this button, it goes to like green. You got your yellow, your blue, your red, and you can change which color corresponds to what DPI in the settings. So I'm just gonna have a quick look at the settings now so you get an idea of what that looks like as well. All right, so here is the actual software right now. Now this is the DPI setting here on the right. So this is what I meant where you actually select what color you want each DPI. You can change it there. So that changes the middle mouse button and the palm rest, but it doesn't actually change the correspond with the ring there. So that's something to bear in mind. The lighting section, again, that was where I went from rainbow to steady to, you know, neon, all that kind of stuff. Or you can just turn it off, change the direction of it there as well. I can change the speed, which is pretty cool. And what else we got? The mouse parameters here, so you can change the mouse sensitivity, the scrolling speed. The mouse itself does feel really smooth at the minute. Right now I've got it on the 1600 DPI-2 setting, and it does feel really nice actually. And it goes all the way up to a massive 12400, which I'm not trying because it'll just be ridiculous and I can't control it then, but that's just something to bear in mind. Polling rate as well, you got 1000 Hz. You can choose the 125 and all them different increments there. And you've also got this debounce time which you can change as well. Now you can select profiles as well, whatever you want to change it to, and you can do the macros as well, so you can change what button does what. So say for example, if you don't want the number 6 to be the DPI loop, you can change it here, you know, to whatever else you want. Multimedia keys, DPI lock, you know, switch polling rate, all that kind of stuff. You can also do the macro editor there, which lets you, you know, type something in your keyboard for example, and you know, assign it to one of the buttons. So that's pretty much for the software. Hope you like the video. If you've got any comments or questions, please let me know in the comment section. There's a link of where to buy it in the description, and please of course don't forget to subscribe. It really helps me out, and thank you very much guys, and catch you on the next one.